guys. Time at St James's Park. Newcastle 1, Arsenal 0. Remarkable. Despite my attempts to prop up the club by buying seemingly every available piece of merchandise, we have lost. And it's a really disappointing day. Really disappointing day. And I think the performance wasn't good. The result is worse, really. And does not leave our league position looking too strong right now. I said after the Liverpool game, I kind of came out with my belief that this wasn't going to be our year in the league. And today did nothing to dissuade me of that. It's interesting, you know, I think back to when Rodri picked up that serious injury and it really felt like, it could be our year. And who knows, like, it could all change, it could all turn around, extraordinary things happen in football. But I have to say, it really does not feel like that right now. I'll let you in on a little behind-the-scenes kind of secret. At the start of this season, I was worried. I was worried about where the squad was at and some of the decisions that had been made. And I nearly made a video which was going to be called something like, I don't know, the five things that I'm most worried about with Arsenal this season. And I didn't do it because I thought, you know, it was around the transfer deadline. And I thought, it's very negative, potentially. I was sort of partly doing it, so, you know, it's a bit of a gotcha to be able to say, look, I called this. But I sort of wish I had now. Because I feel like a lot of those things are coming home to roost. I'll mention a couple now. I always felt we were a creative midfielder light. And as much as I believe in the talent of Ethan Ranieri, my insistence that he should be playing more comes from a lack of alternatives. I think it was a mistake. I thought it was a mistake then. I think so even more now, to let the likes of Vieira and Smith Rowe leave without signing a replacement of that ilk, that type of player. I'm sure Mikel Merino will look a very good player in a team with Martin Odegaard next to him. But without Martin Odegaard, the balance is not right. And I think we look like we desperately lack creative, technical player in that midfield part of the pitch. And I know Vieira wasn't great last year, and I know Smith Rowe wasn't great last year, and maybe that's not his best position. But that was what they were in contention for in the squad. I think letting them go and signing a very different type of midfielder in Merino right now looks like a mistake. Of course, that is all caused by the Martin Odegaard injury, and I think that's been a tremendous blow. But we said it during the run-in last season. He is the one player who we don't have an analogue for, we don't have a replacement for in the squad, and we are suffering for that right now. And I think you could see that potentially coming. What else? Another fear I had was that we just hadn't quite done enough to strengthen the front line. You know, on deadline day, people were kind of appeased by Raheem Sterling coming in. I think the fact that Raheem Sterling didn't even get off the bench today in a situation where Arsenal were desperate for a goal and desperate for points tells you that maybe, you know, it's not quite the impactful addition that we would have hoped for. Again, so far. But I do think, you know, we all looked at it and thought, could we do with another type of centre forward in there? Could we do with some explosive goal scoring off the left flank? Maybe so. Arsenal weren't able to do any of those things. And I always felt that eventually that would catch up to us this season. Listen, I know hindsight's 20/20, and you may say, I'm saying this because we've lost a game. But in all honesty, I had these fears. And when I say fears, I don't think we're going to be bad this season. I never believed that. But when you're trying to wrest the title from Manchester City, what you're asking for really is perfection. And in order to achieve that, you have to continue making real strides forward. And I'm not sure we did that in terms of the squad building. That is my thoughts certainly there have been other factors here, you know, sendings off, injuries, particularly the loss of Odegaard, things that can't necessarily be planned for, that have taken things out of the manager's hands, the player's hands to an extent. But let's come back to the game today, because I think that we put out a really strong 11, you know. Saliba and Gabriel back together, Timber on one side, Partey on the other, White wasn't quite fit enough to start. Rice, Marino, Havertz, Trossard, Martinelli, Saka. I know we're missing some important players, Calafiori, Odegaard. If you want to win a league, it's not an amount of players missing at this stage that is an excuse, in my opinion. And we didn't perform. We really didn't perform. I think Bukayo Saka came out with his head held high. I think he was the guy who always looked like he might make something happen and absolutely should have had an assist in stoppage time with that brilliant cross for Declan Rice. Outside of that, we didn't do enough going forward. I think it was fascinating to see, you know, sometimes your opponent tells you where your weaknesses lie. Anthony Gordon, from what I understand, played 90% of his football this season on the left wing. He played this game on the right. And I think that we often concede goals from situations that develop in that left fullback area. And I think we always look to blame individuals. Oh, it's Zinchenko, he can't defend. Or it's Lewis Skelly, he's naive. It's Calafiori, you know, he's adapting to the English game. But I think it's a structural weakness. And I think that some opposition teams are you know, capable of exploiting that. Newcastle did brilliantly. Wonderful cross, great header. You know, I think people will analyse the defending, but I think sometimes you have to say that's a brilliant delivery and a brilliant finish. But funnily enough, over the rest of the course of the game, I think Newcastle probably came closest or looked like they had more opportunities to add a second than we did to equalise. Apart from that Rice chance, it was slim pickings. It became the sort of game that Newcastle needed it to be. Very physical, bitty, lots of duels. And even with a midfield three of kind of with Rice in it, Marino in it, Havertz dropping in, we didn't win the fight. Not a nice thing to say about your own team, but we didn't win the fight. They're incredibly strong, incredibly physical, like Bruno and Joelinton. And they bossed us, I think. They won free kicks at the right time. They won the ball at important times. And like I say, with Willock and others breaking, they had one or two chances to extend their lead. Where does it leave us? Well, it's not looking great in Premier League terms. And another really hard game to come in the league next week away at Stamford Bridge. That was the thing about the Liverpool game, that draw was fine, but I think a lot of the people who felt Arsenal needed to win were probably looking ahead at what was coming, because Newcastle away and Chelsea away back to back, with Inter Milan away in the Champions League sandwiched in between, is a really tough run. We're 0-1 so far out of those three games, and it's going to be tough for Mikel Arteta to pick up the players and get things working out. I think he's got to change things. I think he's probably got to go back to Havertz is my centre forward. I need a creative player playing off him. That's probably not an area. You know, if I really want to start Trossard, it's probably got to be between him or Martinelli at this point in time. And yeah, I think get Ben White back in at right back and hope that he and Saka can kind of get that relationship going again. Maybe Ranieri will be able to replicate what Odegaard does to a certain extent. Listen, all teams have players that are important to them. But we've got to remember, City are without Rodri. They're without Kevin De Bruyne. And they're doing okay. And that, unfortunately, is what is required. And we're without Martin Odegaard, and we're not coping with it. Um, So yeah, I'm really curious to see how things go the next few weeks. Not just on the pitch, because it doesn't take much for things to change, but also for the fans, because I feel like we've had a really good couple of years, especially we've started seasons with, well, that's not true actually. Last season we were a bit sticky at the start of last season, but we've had a very good couple of years, and we haven't had too many problem moments, right? And I think our anxiety level about like winning the league, we've got to win the league in the next few years is quite high. And so as we wrestle with the possibility that it may be very difficult to do this year, I'm curious to see how we handle that. I'll leave it there for now, guys. Bit of a ramble this one. When are they not? But I'll speak to you Monday in the form of an Askcast Extra, and then I'm off to Milan. So I'll speak to you from Milan over here on YouTube. Take care, guys. Speak soon. Bye bye.